Hey guys, DfieldMark here, and welcome back to a brand new video. I hope you guys are all having a fantastic day today. We are back on the YouTube page to do a different type of video today. I thought that for today's video, we could have a little bit of fun and try to answer a couple of riddles. For some weird reason, guys, YouTube has been kind of recommending all these videos to me. I randomly clicked on this one earlier today, and I started watching like the first 20 seconds of it, and I was like, wait, this would be a freaking cool video to do a reaction on in order to kind of try to solve a whole bunch of riddles with you guys in the comments section. Now, before we go ahead and start, guys, I'm pretty sure this video is going to end up demonetized, so enjoy today's free video. Oh my gosh. Here we go, guys. There are going to be three riddles that we read today, and as I'm reading right here in the description, the three riddles are the late night robbery, theft on board, and the murder mystery riddle. All right, guys, we've got three riddles to solve today. Hopefully you guys go ahead and participate. I actually do like watching and reading these like riddles because they kind of like challenge your brain to think in different ways than you would normally have to think. Anyways, guys, let me know how many of these riddles you guys get correct down in the comment sections below. Here we go, guys, here we go.
Welcome. Today I will show you three detective riddles popular on Who Did It.
Here we go, guys. Oh!
The first one is quite easy. The second one already tricky.
Easy, medium, and hard.
And the third one is very difficult.
Okay, okay.
Write down in the comments which riddles you were able to solve.
Wait, guys, why is it one and one? Isn't it supposed to be like one, two, three? Why is it one, one, one? Wait, what?
Let's get to the first
riddle.
Here
we go. Riddle number one.
In a normal night, when no one expected it, James and Hannah have been robbed of all their valuables.
Oh no!
Fortunately, the police was around, and a couple minutes later, when James called them from home, they were still able to catch all suspects that were around in that area.
Good,
Mark,
good, good.
Paul and Luke.
Mark, Paul, and Luke.
The police knows that one of them has to be the robber, but nobody of them has any of the valuables with him anymore.
Okay, okay.
So they question the suspects. Mark says, Paul is the robber.
Okay.
Paul says, Luke is the robber. And Luke says, Paul is lying. Assuming that robbers lie, uninvolved people tell the truth, and there's just one person involved in the robbery. Can you tell who is the robber?
Wait, 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 can we say that again? He said, assume that bad people lie and innocent people... Wait, what did he say?
Robbers lie, uninvolved people tell the truth.
So we have to assume that robbers lie and What did he say? And then he said, uninvolved people tell the truth. Okay, so...
And there's just one person involved in the robbery. Can you tell who is the robber? Pause the video now if you need more time to think.
Okay, let's pause. So, we have a couple that have been robbed and the police has caught three suspects. All right, guys? One must be the robber, and the robbers are always going to be lying, and any person that is uninvolved will tell the truth. Only one person was involved. So either Mark, Paul, or Luke is going to be our robber, guys, right? So let me go ahead and switch the face cam really fast so then you guys can go ahead and see what the actual criminals are saying. So Mark is saying Paul is the robber. So let's assume that were true. Let's say Paul is the robber, right? Now, Paul is saying Luke is the robber, but we need to assume that robbers lie. So then this guy might be lying about what he's saying. And then Luke is saying that Paul is the robber. But if uninvolved people are telling the truth, that means that Mark and Luke are telling the truth. So then I think that Paul is the robber, guys. That's going to be my final answer, all right? Paul is the robber.
The solution will follow in 3, 2,
come on.
1. Did you come up with the answer?
Yes, Paul.
Paul is the guilty person, as only then it is possible that the two others, Mark and Luke, are speaking the truth.
Yes.
When Mark said, Paul is a robber, he was telling the truth and giving the correct answer.
That's
when
literally
Paul
the
said,
thought process.
Luke is the robber. He was lying, as he himself
That's
is
literally
a lying
the thought
robber.
Process I
when
went
Luke
through, guys.
Paul is lying. He was telling the truth and
easy
affirmed
peasy.
That Paul was lying.
So obviously that was the easiest riddle. Let's see how much harder this
here
actually gets.
Here comes riddle number two.
Riddle number two, here
a
we go.
A Japanese ship is on the route back to the shore from the Atlantic Ocean.
Okay, okay.
In a calm and windless moment, the captain decides to take a shower. He keeps his Rolex and diamond-studded gold bracelet on the shelf and goes for a shower.
Okay,
when
easy
he returns,
enough.
He finds both the watch and the bracelet missing.
Of course, of course.
He immediately calls the four crew members and asks them what they were doing during this time. Mm-hmm. Following are the answers. The cook explained, I was in the kitchen preparing bacon sandwiches for everybody. The engineer said, I was in the generator room checking the generator. The housekeeper told them, I saw that the flag hoisted on the ship was upside down, so I went to correct it. And the second housekeeper said, I was tired and just taking a quick nap. The captain knows that one of them must be lying, and this must be the thief. Can you tell from that information who the thief is?
What the
heck?
Pause
the video now to think about the solution.
Okay, so a Japanese ship is on the way back to shore. While the captain was taking a shower, one crew member stole his Rolex and the gold bracelet. So the cook was preparing bacon sandwiches for everybody. The engineer was in the generator room checking the generator. The housekeeper said the flag was upside down and I went to correct it. And the second housekeeper said he was taking a nap. Okay, so let me go ahead and scrub through this video really quickly. Let's go ahead and see if we can find a couple of clues towards the beginning. So guys, the one main thing that sticks out to me, right, is this ship right here. This is like a sailboat. So obviously you're using wind in order to power the ship is what I'm thinking. So if that's actually the case, I feel like the one who actually ended up robbing the Rolex and the golden bracelet had to be the engineer, guys. Because I don't know, if I'm taking a quick guess, does a ship like a sailboat have an engine room or a generator room? I don't think that's the case. I'm gonna go ahead and go with that guess. Let's see what we got here. Remember, you guys have to be trying to guess out these riddles as well. So let me know how many of you guys get correct down in the comment sections below. Here we go. Let's find out what the answer is. All right.
3, 2, 1.
Who is
right? I really like that riddle because it's only one little detail that reveals the thief.
Okay.
The thief is... the housekeeper.
He
was
what?
Definitely lying because the flag of Japan looks same when upside down or upright. And
oh,
no one can tell if it is
on.
Upside down.
Are Let's you serious? Oh, that one was so hard. Like, I guess I didn't think about it in that sense. I feel like it was like a sailing ship, so I didn't realize that all sailing ships have a generator room, I guess. Oh, man. So I got the easy one right, the medium one wrong. Can we figure out what the hard one is, guys? Ready? Here we go.
The third riddle. This morning, a very famous chemist was found murdered in his kitchen.
Uh-oh.
You are called to make sense from the existing clues.
Okay.
The police is sure that this murder was a two-man job
two-man
and it could
job.
Not have been done alone.
Oh,
and they have
gosh.
Also narrowed it down to 6 remaining suspects.
Oh, gosh.
Their names are Felice, Maxwell, Peter, Nicholas, Philip, and Henry.
Okay.
When they further examined the crime scene, the police found a note with the dead body. The following is written on the note. 26-3-58/28-27-16. And that's already all the information you have. Can you find out who of the suspects are the killers and who are guiltless? Pause the video now to think carefully.
What the heck? A famous chemist has been found murdered in the kitchen and there are 6 suspects: Felice, Maxwell, Peter, Nicholas, Philip, Henry. The only hint you have is a note that has been left by the victim. We have 26-3-58, 28-27-57-16. Who are the murderers? So we need to look for 2 different murderers here. How the heck are we supposed to know this? Wait, hold on. Give me a quick second to think about this, guys. I feel like it's in this actual riddle right here. A famous chemist. Wait, what if we go, can we actually look up the periodic table real quick? Let me look up the periodic table really quickly here, guys, and pull up just a quick image. Let me go ahead and view this image right here in full form. Okay, so in the periodic table, we have a whole bunch of different numbers here, and I'm thinking if we have 26, what's 26? 26 is Fe, and then 3 is Li, so F-E-L-I. And then 58 is right down here, C-E. F-E-L-I-C-E? F-E-L-I-C-E. Felice! Okay, so the first one is Felice. Guys, what the heck? I'm a genius! How the heck did I get this one, dude? The one thing that actually gave it away was the fact that it was a famous chemist. So he had to do something with numbers, and obviously with chemistry, there's the periodic table. So that's like the first thing that came to my head. So it's Felice and 28 and 27, so N-I-C-O. It's gotta be Nicholas. So the 2 murderers are Felice and Nicholas. Oh my gosh, I'm a genius! Let's go!
The solution will follow in 3, 2, 1.
I'm a genius,
this
guys.
This riddle is definitely a difficult one. The numbers on the note that were left by the chemist correspond to atomic numbers on the periodic
yes,
table.
Yes, I knew it!
Have to be the murderers.
There it is, guys!
That were three of my favorite detective riddles. I hope you enjoyed the video, and see you next time.
Oh my gosh. Guys, make sure you guys go ahead and check out the Riddle channel. I'll go ahead and link this video down at the top of the description below. Hopefully they don't claim my video. But guys, how many of these riddles did you guys end up guessing? As you guys saw right there, I got the easy one right, the medium one wrong, and then the hard one correct. So 2 out of 3, not too bad. Let me know how you guys did down in the comment sections below. My name is DfieldMark. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. Make sure you guys come back tomorrow for another daily video. Have a fantastic day, everybody. Peace.